They say about these stones is true, but if it is, well, this is just too good to not save forever. Lystrom was out of town when Artol was visiting. Now, Lystrom doesn't know Artol, and Artol is older and strange. She could be mistaken for a fate weaver. So when Lystrom came back to town, here was Artol the Oracular. I said to Lystrom, I hear her readings are amazing. You should go. Oh, my, you should have seen it. A rooster, she said, will change into a man, and this man will become your lover. He will provide for you, and he will make you laugh, and he will make your life exciting and easier. But, and this is something you can never forget, he must never eat chicken. And once in a while, he will need to peck at things on the ground. Every morning, at the break of dawn, you'll hear a loud cry from him.
May your hollow gods keep you mortal. I am called Eri. Your face is new to me. You are different from those in Gorhart. They amuse me, and I strive to learn all I can from them. Have you come to ask about the Tuatha? I can offer only what I know, and hope it will suffice. I wandered the forest for many seasons, listening to lore stones of the great ballads. Before that, I dwelled in the gardens of Issa. I prefer the quiet of this village, the mirth of the witless. I adore every sad soul in the village, even stubborn Herc with his tender heart, and drunken old Arnik. The widow fascinates me. She has no idea that her lover is dead. I watch them from my perch, hoping to learn the meaning behind their pursuits and passions. If I could, I would grant each of them an eternity. Alas, I cannot. We are kin to the seasons and cycles of all life, to new life and perpetual growth. Mortals may view the warmth of the petals and smell the beauty of a newborn bud, but only fae know the strength of the roots beneath the surface. I cannot reveal much. The gardens are the jewel of the summer court, a wonder beheld by few mortals. It is located far east of here in a wood so thick it would devour all but those who knew its secrets. Do not pursue such mysteries, mortal. They are not for you. I find them so interesting, from their vestments to their odd habits and demeanors. Just yesterday, I saw a monk from the Almain Mission sneaking through the underbrush. Strange creatures you are. Strange, but glorious. They contain memories, great moments, ideas, songs, and inspirations. The Fae do not record their words in ink or on paper. Ink fades, paper crumbles. Lore stones mark where our kind has made a lasting impression, where the season slowed to take note of glory on a grand scale. Fae lands? Yes, I've heard these words before, but do not understand their meaning. There are only Fae, and there is only land. I do find Almain sentiments so charming. I feel them near, flitting through the western woods like shafts of shadow in the sunlight. What could have brought them here, I wonder? The Tuatha do not trouble themselves with easy prey. If they prowl these woods, it is for worthy quarry. Yes, I witnessed this crime, although I did not recognize the one who perpetrated it. It is often difficult to distinguish one mortal from another. The victim was Illuvia, but I knew her only by name. You must be hoping that I can offer advice, but I cannot. If she is meant for the great cycle, then so be it. However, I would be quite interested to find out whether one of my kind would benefit from one of your mortal remedies. I've always wondered. It will need to be powerful. Your delicate forms are far more sensitive than ours. In fact, it's astounding that you survive as long as you do. All of us are at the mercy of the changing seasons, mortal and fae alike. If it is one's time to pass into the great cycle, then we must not protest. The passing is keeping with autumn, and is as natural as the eventual rebirth. Perhaps your mortal apothecary can provide one. You can always create the potion yourself if you possess the skill. Farewell.
secret to tell you. I am not sad. When I was a girl, my father used to tell me that when you grow old with someone, you tie your fates together and create a pattern that is part yours and part theirs. My father said that this is why when an old person dies, their partner is never far behind. But I do not feel that way. I feel free.
Let's see how this works.
For it.
Yes? What could a mortal vagabond need with Kazmaran, the Eternal, Messenger of the Fae Folk? Speak! My time may be of the ages, but it is still precious.
It sounds rather silly, doesn't it? I had a feeling it would. I need a mage name for when I become all-powerful, for when my magic is so great that no one will dare dispute me. What about Abner the Visionary, or Malik the Nefarious, Lord Zaltanus? No? And those were the good ones. Mortal races have no lasting grasp on this world, and in time the fair ones shall be our masters, beautiful and mighty. I'm new to the Feylands. Until I joined the mission, I'd never even left my home village. That's why I volunteer. I want to visit the gardens of Issa, to meet gnomes and Alfar, to live. The Order of Mitharu was a good way to leave home, but I want so much more. Legend tells of the great Fae city hidden beneath the canopies of Dalantarth. I've never met anyone. Yes, I'm quite sure. Not a doubt in my mind. Father Dimwell and the others are fools, and their silly mission will wither and crumble. Finna and Arbos have glimpsed it with their ever-seeing eyes. They believe I have the potential to succeed where all others have failed. You see, they can't obtain what they desire, so they need someone more powerful to do it. Then they will bestow upon me the wisdom of the Fae. Wait! Father Dinwell sent you, didn't he? Old fool. His path to power was too plodding, and now he wishes to slow me down too. They are named Finna and Arbos, and they have sworn to share their secrets with me and to... In exchange, they want an ancient treasure buried in the caverns of Waterhall Down. I'll retrieve it, eventually, as soon as I... They are Fae twins, and they are beautiful, magical creatures. They've promised... All they require of me is to fetch for them this relic. It's quite a bargain, believe me. Fine, if you want to be so noble, but don't expect any of the treasure. This is my key into a powerful new future, a future full of magic and wonders. Let's go! It is called the Selkie Vale, and it's said to possess the power to transform its wearer into any form he wishes. Finna says it belongs to the Fae, but was... It is in the caves of Waterhall Down, a refuge for the wild Fae. See you later. If we're going to press on, then I'll ask you to stay close. I have no courage to speak of. Honest, ask Father Dinwell. I don't know much about the relic, only that it was supposedly crafted by a Fae. Armin is a good name. Not as good as Kazmaran, though. Local legend says that the great Fae mage Armin the Clever retreated to these caverns to hide his among them, the Selkie Vale. Goodbye now.
will be all powerful. Thank you. Our bosun Finna will be waiting. Come, their camp is not far.
Finna and Arbos made their camp in the old Fey ruins north of the village, near my camp. See you later.
What now? What is this? A little Egan has made a friend? I have a feeling this is going to be a problem. Before the war, we plundered Rothfear from within. We were so successful that the Warsworn had bounties on our heads. Not much, but enough to be proud of. Sadly, all good things must come to an end. With the arrival of so many wartime outlaws, we were forced to relocate here. It was for the best, if you ask me. A charming boy, but simple. My brother and I do prefer them witless and eager. He would have done so much more for us if legend states that the wearer of the veil will be granted strange abilities. Fey abilities. So, you can imagine why my brother... Obviously, anyone who has ever glimpsed a Fey would know that. Unlike little Egan here, your head holds more than fantasies. The Feylands are such fertile ground for games. The inhabitants are so oafish, you can fill your pockets with hardly any effort. Are you going to give us what's rightfully ours, or do we need to start a new game? My brother and I are always ready to play. Then you'll have to pay for it with your life. You see, we have much invested in this deception. Blood, gold, not to mention the hours wasted on Egan. We may be criminals, but we're an honourable pair. We worked hard for our prize, and now we mean to have it. Cursed, is it? It does look like you are well acquainted with misfortune. Keep the veil, then. There are other treasures to be had in the Feylands. Make certain our paths do not cross again, or my brother will add his mark to your scars. Goodbye. You best get baby Egan back to his bassinet. His mother will be worried.
I didn't know. How could I? Before I came to Gorehart, I'd never known anyone outside my... You must think me a fool. And Father Dinwell. Come. Goodbye now.
I hope you're brighter than poor Egan. From the looks of it, I'd say probably not. My twin sister and I share a very close relationship. It allows us to work fluidly, without consultation. I don't care enough to have an opinion of the poor fellow, I'm afraid. He flits in and out of my thoughts, never registering. The most useful fools are the ones who never leave an impression. Farewell.
Must we return to the mission? I crave adventure, magic, power. Although all of those things are quite frightening. Perhaps it is for the best. This new world is far more dangerous than I expected, and I haven't eaten in days. Bye then.
Great Mitharu, Egan has returned. As for you, you have done as I asked, and we here at St. Odwig's are forever grateful. Consider this meager reward a donation to your cause. It is just one, to be sure. It is only by the grace of Mitharu that Egan has been returned to us. Of course, you had a hand in that miracle.
Welcome back.
I'm glad you are well. The men and women of Gorhart are good people, but I tend not to socialize with them. Their concerns are their own. Mitharu has led us to this hilltop for a reason, and that is to end the phase long. These poor creatures crave order. Look around you. This whole forest is a shrine to nature, which it... Her lies and accusations border on heresy. That one better watch her words, lest they coil back to bite her in the... His curiosity got the best of him, and we almost lost him. He's a good soul, but young. This mission was founded to aid all those seeking Mitharu's divine order. There are others as well. St. Hadwin's is east of here. He is the authority, the great creator, the being of supreme order. All Almain claim him as their own. Make yourself at home.
This can't be happening. Oh, I didn't see you come in. I was reading this letter and... Is there anything I... Can I... I never thought it would happen. Coming. Even with everything else going on in this village, the Red Legion is coming for me. The people here are kind, yet suspicious. They believe the mission harbors secret. I'll admit it. My past is a tapestry of drunkenness and loose morals, women and wine. I'm not proud of it, but filled the hunger I was hoping to sate with wine, women. I was not always the pious man you see before you. No, I was a scoundrel, a raider in the dreaded Red Legion, a gang of the notorious bandit Red the Dead Idward. But plunder could not sustain me. I wanted something... more. Several of us faked our deaths and deserted. It's all here in Red's letter. He demands we satisfy the blood rite, Two lives for one. He'll let me go, but only if I kill them. I could hand myself over to Red, but he'd have me killed. The only other choice is to kill the men who left with me. I can't do that. I'm not the man. I do what I must. I only hope Ugnar and Itrin will forgive me. Ugnar works in Gorhart village. Itrin haunts the ruins near Haxi, still struggling with his demons. Be on your guard. When it's finished, take their daggers and bring them to Red Edward. He will demand proof. Take mine to start. Good luck, my friend. Maymith, Ugnar could always be found by Red's side, Red's right hand. But beneath his brutal exterior, Ugnar was a good man. Itrin, however, rivals only Red Edward in his bloodlust. They say he was once a Justicar, but was expelled for brutality. His devotion to his god Enidon is fanatical. I fought under Red for years, yet I know nothing of him. I do know this. He will do anything to get what he wants. The most dangerous kind of... It is a sacrament of the Red Legion. When you commit a crime, you must pay a penance. Sir Ugnar works for the inn at Gorhart. Itrin has taken to calling himself the Shade. And Mitharu is with you.
Come to protest the mission as well. The news has spread to every village. It's on every tongue. We are so close. St. Odwig's cannot resist much longer. And once it relents, all others will follow in its wake. The tome will be ours. Father Dinwell is denying that women can be ordained as members of the Order of Mitharu. I know that they've got the proof in their reliquary, an ancient ordination tome. But they've never let me close enough to get a glance. All are welcome into Mitharu's embrace. Ha! The hypocrites! Don't commit any crimes on my account. Of course, if Mitharu compels you to see justice done, then I won't stand in your way. The Brothers of St. Odwig's perpetual mission keep the valuable tome in their reliquary, but no one outside the Order is...
Need something? Need supplies? Try the corner shop.
Time is of the essence. That's never been more true. I think I'm able to part with anything, much less one of my finest mixtures. This is a place of research. There is no charity. I'm sure I have a vial somewhere in this cottage, but I do not have the time to search for it. I'm sorry. Farewell.
Need supplies? Try the corner shop.
You've returned. Time is of the essence. That's never been... more true. Farewell.
I am Catrin. Do you require my healing touch in mind, body, or both? This has been my home ever since my love was taken by the Tuatha. After such a loss, one craves quiet. But it's the Gnome's Tower stands to the west, past Gorhart and beyond the ruins of Alistar Glade. However, no one should seek Alistar. Its secrets I am unable to watch while others suffer. Too many mortals have fallen prey to the Tuatha, and I could not stomach it. So I left my home in Rathir and traveled west. There are many Almain villages just like this one, yearning for peace, crying out in pain. What good are my gifts if I cannot make what is broken? The Almain were once different tribes that recently banded together to form an empire. They are formidable creatures, but new to the way of magic. Magic is a natural wonder, no matter how you use it. The Tuatha are the exception. Their power is the glorious Alfar city to the east is where the forces of right gather to face the Tuatha. It is an enchanting place with a long history of magic. I require a nominal fee only so I may eat and have a bed to call my own. I buried everything I was when I buried my family. That is the war's legacy for many of us. That is all I can. Find the fair folk if you wish to learn the ways of magic. They understand this world in a way that is hidden from mortals. You will find many fae in Dalantarth, as it is one of their ancestral homes. The forests of this region are one of the densest in all of Armalore, and the stretch from Alistar to Issa. Those of us who live in the shadow of its canopy call Dalantarth the Feylands, because this is where these fair folk have their seat of power. Be careful out there.
The Red Legion is about. Best to sleep with your sword by your side.
What is it? You made it. Just in time, too. Give me the potion. It will help, but it's not enough. Someone must go to the Fae and explain what happened here. One small misunderstanding and we'll no longer just be strangers to the Fae. We'll be enemies. She is a member of the House of Ballads, the legendary court of Fae heroes. They are warriors without equal, with centuries of glory to their names. If one of their own was killed by a mortal, the House of Ballads and its king would bring a fierce vengeance upon us. Gorehart would be a ruin by day's end. I'm not sure yet, but this is bad. She's Fae. Even worse, she's a knight in the House of Ballads. If the House of Ballads learns of this, the king will burn Gore. We could go to the Warsworn and get an oath of protection, but that would require payment. We mustn't cover this up. But who do we tell? You're turning out to be very helpful, my friend. You have my gratitude. I'll see to it that you're honored. Rumor says that the House of Ballads has its headquarters not far from here, in Glendara to the northeast. Try to gain entrance if you can. All I know is what I learned in my youth. The heroism of King Wenson and his court of enchantments. My grand spoke of them nightly as she sat by my bedside. For all I know, the House of Ballads is nothing more than myth. But I have a feeling that it exists somewhere out in the deep mists of the Feylands. Once they fought the Beasts of Chaos, marching to glory through many victories. Sadly, they fell, as all great men do. Now they're nothing more than hired blades. Anyone can earn their allegiance with a few pieces of gold. It's east of here, in the meadows of Yolvin. The Feylands are a wicked place, crawling with creatures so strange you'll assume you're dreaming. Farewell.
What's this? Times are hard, but hard times can pay if you're willing to take risks. If you have the sword and stomach for this sort of work, we could use another strong arm among the Warsworn. Peaceful enough, if it's peace and quiet you like. Trouble with bandits and rogues now and then. That's when they send for me. That's me, Warsworn since before you've been drawing breath, an Oathblade near as long. Easy now, stripling. Earn your way to Pledge Shield first. Then, in 5 or 10 years good service, you'll make Oathblade. There's a war in the east. And Dalantarth's got our own troubles with the Red Legion thieves. Some say they've seen Tuatha in these parts. Fools, I'll believe that when I see it. What have you been living under? We've been at war with the Tuatha for 15 years. A name taken by some lot of scoundrels to glorify their thievery. A name breeds fear and doesn't die like a man. But Shieldring, the oldest home to the Warsworn, in the Feylands at least. They're unlike any Fae you've ever seen. Red eyes to match their armor, and fierce as rabid wolves. Fae are folk, but not mortal folk. They're not concerned with the things. Some may try to color it with fancy words, but we're warriors for hire, the best in these lands. You'll find those who have taken the oath are held in the highest respect all over Amalur. You could head straight to Shieldring Keep and pledge your sword. Might work, but a commendation from me would carry a lot of weight. To earn it, you must do something commendable. There are two brothers, scoundrels of the Red Legion. Now bring me proof you've dealt with them. I'll pay in coin and my good word. Osgar hides somewhere in the woods north of here. Medgar was bring me their legion daggers, and I'll pay with coin and a commendation to join the order. Right then.
Don't be shy. Come in.
Stay alert. Tell Gisella if you see her husband.
Hey there.
If only the Alfar would have taken me.
Pull up a stool, stranger. We don't have much, but what we have won't leave a hole in your pocket. Are you here about that Fey girl they found outside? It's as good a place as any, I guess. The Fae are strange, but I worry more about Nanny Henry, the creepy old alchemist. New to the area? I don't recall the last time I met some. There are two groups. There used to be one, but that was many years ago. The Losulfar are cool, slightly aloof. The Dokulfar, however, are very friendly, but their charm, nothing of interest to tell. I'm just a simple farm girl from the plains of Erythel. I left home as a girl and travelled west. Found myself here and I feel terrible about what happened to that girl. Gorehart used to be a nice little village. These days we're jumping at shadows. All I know is what I've heard from others. They say that the fair Matt would explain the beauty of these woods. I must be honest. Sometimes I forget who we are fighting. All I know is that the humans and Alfar have been battling the enemy vast rolling hills east of here near the coast. You should head that way if you wish to join the war effort. The Alfar need all the help. The mission. I will say this. It's a waste of good lads, that Order of Mitharu. Not many available suitors in Gorehart, if you haven't known. I've worked here since I was a girl. Arnik runs an honest business, and Ugnar if you need a healer's touch, Katrin works out of a room upstairs. She's Alfar, but I wouldn't hold that. Nice talking to you.
Well?
Hello?
Hello. We've buried so many in the cemetery on the hill.
I don't feel comfortable with a Fae in Gorehart.
I hope the Warden's able to heal that Fae girl. She didn't deserve to get beat.
Behave yourself. Need something?
Make it quick. I've got work to do. Can't pay my debts with firewood, not in Gorehart. But I knew it was only a matter of time, and I'm not surprised. Delph will do anything to save it. If you want to collect my dagger, you'll have to fight me for it. Steel for steel. I used to be quite the scrapper. Didn't Delph tell you that? Edward knows where I am. When he shows up, the only thing to keep me from death is still having this knife. You're right. I've spent years trying to bury my past, hoping to wash away my sins with an honest day's work. Take my dagger, tell him I'm dead. For the Ugnar Oddgrey he once knew is truly gone. This is folly, you know that.
Live for the rest of my life without him knowing, well then I'll deal with that. I think there's something to be said for it. I think it's noble. Yeah, I could tell someone, but that's just asking for praise. What makes it an act of kindness is that nobody knows, or at least that he doesn't know. I let him have the glory. No one has to know his arrow missed. He saved the town. He's a hero.
this?
What are you doing down here? Don't you know Agnar Farhold is haunted by the spirits of the Arathi?
So? Are you foolish or just stupid?
She, like so many others in Gorehart, is prone to ignorance. She sees what she... Her whole life is a lie, she tells herself. They're very careful about whom they allow into their ranks. And they were resistant about mine. Her discovery will fetch a high price in Rhaetir. Could even decide this misbegotten war. Still, that is no concern of mine. I'm skilled in alchemy, but it has never brought me riches or respect. The only way I will ever find glory in this life is that not much is known about the fabled beings of order. They abandoned this world long ago, leaving... I hope that by spreading tales of spirits and boogeymen, they could prevent the curious villagers from exploring too deeply. One can...
Ooh, I see. The twisted gnome has found herself a champion. How delightful. Nanny always was a fool. So immersed in her work that she failed to see the deception before her very eyes. The Red Legion has her formula, because I gave it to them. At this very moment, they are moving crates of it eastward towards the city of Rhaetir, where they will fetch a high price.
Poor Nanny. So trusting, so pathetic. I'm sorry.
Hard to believe. But you can accept the strangest fact that you were wrong. Yes, but that and this endless vacuity is horrible.
The Ancient Ones were here. They delivered themselves into the world. The time-worn cycle turns with ages. The seasons drift along the stream. They wait for the past. The future brings the forming storm. This is no place for a home, for anyone. These walls are grown, are built for stone. Lovingly, this place was crafted. You see the lights, the mystic halls of ordered reality? They are the faces of the missing, the embodied truth of the lost souls. There are so many of them. Still, you can see them. They are like pathetic charades, some with good intentions, and you can't fault them that. But the majority of them are just a hoax. Needless to say, I don't like it here. You could have stayed free and lived a comfortable life, but you couldn't settle a disquiet that haunts people like you.
Thank you. our Red Legion.
Be on your guard. The Red Legion are all about, and they do not... Take prisoners. Goodbye.
Right.
place this maiden's role, a burdensome and heavy toll. She lived among the mortals and bargained with them. Throughout the town, they stood in fear of the brilliant fighter near.
Everyone in Gorhart is talking about the attacks. They say that the Red Legion is received. It is all thanks to you. You found the formula and destroyed it. Now, you may think you understand the impact of this act, but you truly do not. You are a friend to this village and to me, Nani Hanri. Take this. It is not much, but it gives you an idea of my gratitude. He seems so eager to aid me in my work that I failed to pursue the proper references. How was I to know he was a scout and a thief? His interest in alchemy appeared genuine. Our friendship, was that too an act? Goodbye.
Nice to see you.
You're welcome in my shop anytime. And please enjoy a discount on all services and merchandise. Goodbye.